So in this video, I'm going to talk about a PS2 game called Dead to Rights. Well, it's also on Xbox and PC, and I believe on... it's probably on other platforms as well. I think there's a GameCube version, maybe. But I played on PS2. So, it really shouldn't make a difference, though, which platform you play. Xbox version is probably the best, because Xbox of multi-platform games were known to have, you know, better load times, better frame rates, you know, just overall better, and, you know, internal memory makes things faster. Whereas PS2, you have to use your usual memory card, which makes things a little slower to save and to load. But other than all that, it's really the same game. And the game, in my opinion, I really did not enjoy this game at all. In fact, I never finished the game because I got stuck at one part and didn't bother to kind of move past that. The part I got stuck was in defusing this bomb. You know, to defuse the bomb, you have this circuit and you're rolling the ball around or something. I remember it being some kind of a get this ball to here kind of game. Kind of mini game, and it was very, I don't know why, but I always kind of messed up when at the very last part, getting this ball past this silver ball past here. I kept doing it, and the bomb kept blowing up, so I was like, forget it, I'm done with this game. But the reason why I was done with the game was, I mean, the intro cutscene, or the introduction, was actually pretty interesting, but the premise of the story is really, really basic. You know, you're just a cop that gets framed for murder, so you're on your revenge, or something like that. I don't really remember too much of it. Yeah, that's right. I'm right. You're a cop framed for murder, and now you're out, you know, trying to find out what happened. And you have your trusty little dog. The dog, I guess, is the gimmick behind the game. When you know, it's just a regular third-person shooter with horrible gunplay mechanics. The gunplay mechanics are just bad. You know, you kind of lock on and shoot, but the guns do very weak damage, and the enemies are just like running around. There's like hardly any. Well, back in the days, there's not many cover systems to speak of. But even so, you kind of just pop in, run out, and it's not very fun shooting game, I don't think. But there's a lot of shooting involved, and there's a lot of that the thing that kind of you could do is, you know, you rack up your kills, you can also go up to them and disarm them, you can melee kill them, you could send out your dog, and your dog will just tear off the limbs of the enemies and stuff like that. That's the gimmick. The dog is the gimmick. And also, the dog becomes a crucial part of the gameplay as well, when sometimes you play as the dog. You take control of the dog, and you snip out different smut, and you follow the scent, and because dog can get to areas where the main character can't. I don't remember his name. It's been a long time since I played the game. I'm not willing to play this again, because I didn't enjoy it at all. So it just has a mix, a lot of a mix of stuff. You know, it has shooting, third-person shooting. It has dog controlling. It has rail sequences. It has bomb defusing. Rail sequences, when you're on the helicopter, there's a rail sequence. And a boss battle here and there, but boss battles are really just tiresome. It's just really repetitive and long. There's no strategy. It's just the same gun and shooting again. So, really, it's just another one of those third-person shooters that, you know, gives you an excuse to kill people, an excuse to do all these random activities, and all these shootings. It can be mindless fun, I guess, but it's really nothing much more than that. And I don't know. I'm not a big fan of those. Big fan of like these kind of, I call them like meaningless games. They're just kind of good to enjoy, you know, just kick back, eat popcorn, and watch, and play. And Dead to Rights is kind of those games, but it's just mired by, like, the control mechanics are not all that well, and it's easy to get stuck in some parts because of the how the game is. The rail sequences are probably the best parts of the game. But if you're playing a game for the rail sequences, there's something wrong with that. And that's why I really didn't like Dead to Rights at all. It's a passable game. It's surprising that people liked it enough, or people bought it enough so that there's a sequel, Dead to Rights 2. And then there was a sequel after that on the HD consoles, you know, PS3, 360, and PC. I haven't ever checked them out. I don't know if I should, because I really didn't like Dead to Rights 1 at all. But, you know, that's just my thoughts on the game. It's just one of those, you know, shooter meaningless titles that you just play to enjoy and kill time.